Hello everyone, it's Farkad here. In this video, I'm going to show you the values of every consumable in the game. Now this is where I've been for the last week or so, trying to fix all this up and work out all the numbers. Now this is all on the wiki. I thought about doing a video on it, like detailed with all images and fancy movements and all that sort of stuff, but this stuff changes so much that the video would probably be outdated in a couple of patches. I thought putting it on the wiki would be a better idea. And that way I can keep it updated, and it's all raw number stuff. It's pretty dry, though I'm going to highlight some of the stuff that I found. There's some stuff in here that I wasn't even aware of. Now I'm 99% sure it's accurate. I spent a lot of time testing this, but because of the amount of numbers, I can't be 100% sure. Now the best way to use it is to use the arrows up here. For instance, if we click on here, it will organize highest to lowest. And it's the same with every other one. Now, normal and hard modes have the exact same values for their food and water. Though polluted water in hard mode is the same as hard survival, there are no other differences between normal and hard mode with consumables. So keep this in mind. I wasn't able to change this in the table because it's all the same otherwise. And hard survival is separate. Same with calories because it's only relevant to hard survival mode. But the rest, like stamina, sanity, inventory space, stew combinations, and sickness, is the same across all difficulties. So this one is hunger, hydration, health, energy, and it's the same across of hard survival, calories, stamina, sanity, storage, stew ingredient, and sickness. Now what the sickness face means, I couldn't find a better one. I think that looks all right. Each of these items have a 20% chance of making you sick each time you consume them. Drinking with hands, I couldn't think of anything better. That's when you drink out of a pond. Don't do it. Especially on hard survival, gives you 5 hydration and minus 20 health. Not recommended. It's best to collect it with the water skin or the old pot. Some of the interesting things I found were aloe, coneflower, chicory, marigold, booze, meds, herbal medicine plus, energy mix plus, food trays, soda, snacks, blueberries, blackberries, deer mushrooms, liberty cat mushrooms, puff mushrooms, and chanterelle mushrooms. That was a bit of a speech. All have the exact same values in normal, hard, and hard survival. There's actually no difference. The biggest differences lie in the meat, and mainly between the energy. For example, a fresh-cooked rabbit will give you 80 energy on normal and hard mode, but only 28 in hard survival. And also, it will heal you 20 health, but in hard survival, only heal you 7 health. Though there are some interesting finds, there are only 3 items in the game that actually restore your stamina, so you can use these in an emergency. Energy Mix Plus, Soda, and Energy Mix. Energy Mix Plus is the best at 60, Soda's next best at 50, and Energy Mix at 30. Depends if you want calories. Another interesting find was cone flour. It actually heals you for 10 health on all difficulties, whereas aloe will only heal you for 2 health on all difficulties. Now, enhanced survival mode is supposed to give you 5 less hydration each time you eat a berry, but it's exactly the same in every difficulty mode. The next one is snowberries, twinberries, amanita mushrooms, and jack mushrooms. They're only minus 2 health on normal and hard mode, but on hard survival, it's minus 30. So 4 berries or 4 of these mushrooms will kill you. It's insane how much damage they do. Oysters, when they're spoiled, they don't give any values at all. So no hunger and no energy. And it's minus 2 health on normal and hard, minus 30 on hard survival. You get 10 calories though. My advice is when they're spoiled, get rid of them. Polluted water is another one. In normal and hard, it's only 1 damage. But on hard survival, it's 20. It's 20 times as much. So only use it if you're very thirsty. And don't drink with your hands. It's terrible. Booze is the only item that reduces your energy, and it reduces it by 10. Though it also gives you 15 health and 50 hydration. Also gives 2 hunger. Guess there's some calories in it. But a unique thing about booze is that it resets your cold status. Meaning if you're about to take frozen damage, you can drink one to prevent that. It's a little bit gimmicky. I've never found a use for that. Though you might. Meds and Herbal Medicine Plus both heal you for 100, though meds are quite common, so it kind of makes it a bit redundant to make Herbal Medicine Plus. Herbal Medicine only heals 50. I don't know, I think they need to reduce the amount that meds heal by about 50, because it's too common. All fresh meats aside from limbs will heal you. It's 20 on normal and hard, but 7 on hard survival. One of the biggest differences between hard survival mode and the other modes is the limbs. Fresh and normal and hard gives you 98 hunger, 20 health, and 80 energy. In hard survival, it gives you 7 fullness, 4 energy, and minus 5 health. It's actually really strange in hard survival with limbs. If you eat a leg or an arm when it's fresh, it will damage you 10 health points, but it will heal you 5. So it damages you, but then it heals you. It's really strange. And as you can see here, in hard survival, once limbs get spoiled or edible, they just become terrible. Edible was 3 fullness and 2 energy, and spoiled was 2 fullness and 1 energy, and the minus 10 health. And if they're dried, you get minus 20. By the way, that's another big difference. In normal and hard mode, dried meats will reduce your hydration by 5 each. In hard survival, it's 20. Keep this in mind. One thing I did not know and I had no clue about was burnt meat. Burnt meat in normal and hard mode will reduce your hydration by 10. In hard survival, it will reduce it by 40. That's insane. This must be a new feature that was added in the full release because I don't remember it doing this. There is one benefit to burning your meat. If it's spoiled, it removes the spoiled status. Any meat that becomes burnt just becomes a flat burnt. So fresh, edible, and spoiled, once they're burnt, all become the same type of meat. And it's not very good, as you can see. It even reduces the calories by half, so in hard survival, it's still not that good. Though if you're desperate and you've got a lot of water, you know what to do. Another interesting thing is that coneflower, aloe, and chicory only have 1 calorie each, even though it states in the inventory it's like 5 or 10, I can't even remember. But marigold has 5 calories. I don't know how that works, but it does. An interesting thing about marigold, it replenishes 5 fullness, but it gives you no energy. Keep this in mind if you're after energy, don't go wasting it. And also, same with coneflower, it gives you no energy. So if you're low on energy, don't spam these ingredients, because it's just a waste. Also, coneflower is probably going to be my new favorite thing. There's no point in wasting a whole meds just to heal a little bit. And coneflower is just about everywhere and you can grow it. Though chicory is good for increasing your energy. It gives you 10 each one. That can be handy. All the mushrooms have 10 calories and they all provide 10 fullness except for Jack and Amanita mushrooms. They only give you 5. And be careful too in hard survival. They're very poisonous. With the berries, only blackberries and blueberries will give you hydration. The other ones won't. So snowberries and twinberries can't be used to get hydration. They'll also injure you, and quite severely on hard survival. The small meat stats are quite disappointing. I wouldn't recommend it. Though if you're desperate, I suppose it would help. Though to give you an example, a fresh cooked small meat gives the same fullness as a spoiled fish and other meats. And the healing's piss poor too. Same with the energy. None of these values cover stews. I recommend checking out the stew page and looking at the video for a guide on how to make stews. They are very good if you want to play a proper survival game. Now I've put the head in here. It can only be stewed and it gives you minus 3 sanity. Its values are really weak, but in hard survival can be good for calories because it's 600. Something you might not have been aware of is that snacks heal you by 5. It's good to know. Its energy is really bad though. It's only 20, whereas soda's at 80. Something that's not listed here is that in hard survival, meats spoil 25% faster. I should add it. There's some key information here that outlines pretty big differences between them. So like twinberries, snowberries, amanita mushrooms, jack mushrooms do 20 times more damage on hard survival. Polluted water ratio is 1 on normal and 20 on hard survival, which means that it does 20 times more damage in hard survival. It also quenches thirst 25% less. Though I believe this only affects drinking water with your hands from fresh water sources. Also, spoiled food does 5 times more damage in hard survival. I do have some basic tips at the bottom. I'm going to be working on that a little bit more, just to help people who are new to the game and want to understand what the foods do and how to get them, that sort of thing. I thought about adding a forest map link to the table, but I think it's starting to become too convoluted. It's already looking a bit like a mess. Though I will be adding more tips to this, which will be good for the new players. And if you're unsure what the key means again, just click this. Opens it up, shows you what it is. Anyway, that's it. Videos like this are sometimes best left to the wiki. If I made a proper video, it would have come out really dry and hard to listen to. It would have been death by PowerPoint. But I thought I'd highlight the things I found interesting and hopefully you found them interesting too. Some things in the forest don't need dedicated videos like this. Either it's too simple or too complicated. It's best left to a wiki. Now this page can't be vandalized, it's only set to admins who can edit it. If you do notice any errors or there are any changes that I'm not aware of, let me know and I'll fix them up. It's good to finally know what consumables are best for each situation. A link for this page will be in the description. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Cheers.